Okay, so good morning everyone. In the last class, we have discussed the concepts of central tendency, mean, median and mode. So let's see the first question of this exercise. Okay. The following number of goals were scored by a team in a series of 10 matches. Find the mean, median and mode of these three scores. Okay, so finding mean is not a difficult class. We all know how to do. We can say this is x1, x2, x3, x4, x5, 6, 7, 8, 9, x10. So we can say the mean will be given by x bar is equal to summation or sigma xi upon n. Where I goes from where to where class? Please tell. I goes from. In the symbol, what will we write? We will write I is equal to 1 to 10 upon n. So this formula we will use to find the value of this mean. It is similar to the last one that we have done in previous classes. Now finding the median. To find the median, we have done before also. We have to first do what, class? To find median, median is actually the middle value. First we see the order of the given information, because if you find middle value in this haphazard manner, it will not give you the correct answer. So first you need to arrange the data either in ascending order or descending. So first let's arrange this. What will we get? The first value will be, let us take blue pen only. Okay, the first value will be 0, 1, then 2 is there. So do we have to write this every time while finding mean? Vaishnav, try to understand and use this, because in higher classes you will be using such symbols more often. So just for your practice, try to write the formula whenever possible. Okay, now 0, 1, 2, after that 3 is coming 3 times, I think. 3 is 4 times, Anuranjan, thank you. After that, what are we having? 4, 2 times. Then we are having 5. Is it done? Yeah, it is done. So, we can see we have arranged the data in a ascending order. Now to find the median, first we go for counting the number of terms. The number of terms are 10. That means it is even number of terms. So class, what to be done? Because in the case of odd numbers, it was very easy to find the median. Suppose this 5 was not there, you could have easily said 1, 2, 3, 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4, and 3 is a median. But in this case, we have even number of terms. That is the issue. So, what to be done? Let me undo this thing. Yes, Utkarsh. Little lag is there today. Okay, done. Fine. To find, in the case of even number of terms, we have a formula, and that is median if n equal to even number, that is the number of terms, it is equal to mean of n by 2th and n by 2 plus 1th term. Or you can say it is given by n by 2th plus n by 2 plus 1th upon 2. This is the formula to find median in the case when there are even number of terms. Have we done this median thing in class 8 for finding for even numbers? Please confirm. Have we done this even number case in 8th also? Class, please confirm. Have we found? okay, we have not done this thing. So this is new for you. I hope this is clear to everyone. To find the median of even number of terms, you will get two numbers first, then you will add them and divide by 2. Okay, now let's see and find the values. What is the value of n right now? Let's put in the formula as n equal to 10. Okay, you taught this earlier also. Okay. Maybe for your information, I gave you in the class 8 also. So let's see. So as n equal to 10, let's put the value. It is 10 upon 2th term plus 10 upon 2 plus 1th term upon 2. So class, we have got 5th plus 6th term upon 2. Now we have to check which term is the 5th term. Please tell. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th. This is the 5th term as well as this is the 6th term. Both are 3 only. So we'll replace the position. 5th number is 3. 6th number is 3 upon 2. Therefore, the median will be 3 only. The median will be 3 only. Okay, now I remember. In the starting of the chapter only, I gave you the idea. Now I remember. In the starting of chapter only, I gave you the idea of median. Fine. Thank you. Okay, now see. So median is done. Now, the thing of mode. Mode is the value which is coming the maximum number of times. And in our case, the mode is obviously 3 because it is coming 4 times. Class, please confirm. Is finding median clear to you? To find median, first we arrange the data either in ascending order or in descending order. After that, we have to count the number of terms. So median is done in two cases. When n is odd number, it is very simple. Just by the formula, n plus 1 by 2th term, you can find the median. And if n is equal to even number, like in the question that we have done just now, you can see it is given by n by 2th plus n by 2 plus 1th upon 2. So these are the two ways to find median. In this case, we get a new value more often, but this is from the data only. Okay. Now let's see question number 2. In a mathematics test given to 15 students, the following marks out of 100 are recorded. So there are 15 students. Okay. Simple data. Find the mean, median, and mode. Very simple. N equal to 15 now. Finding mean is simple. You will just write the formula sigma xi, where I is equal to 1 to 15 upon n. This will be your x bar. Just write this and put the sum of all these values and find the answer. Okay, one more hint for you. Whenever you have to find median and you know this thing, better to write the number in the starting only as in ascending order. Why to wait for this median part? In the starting only, you can write in that way. Question number 3. The following observations have been arranged in ascending order. So already they have arranged the data in ascending order. If the median of the data is 63, they are giving you the median from their side as 63, and they are saying find the value of x. So class, you can see in this question, there are some variables. Two values are not known to you in the terms of x. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. N equal to 10. In this, we have n equal to 10. We will try to find the median using our formula. The value that we will get will be in terms of x. You just need to equate that value with this given median. Can you try this on your own? Please confirm. Or shall I give you some hint of this once again. You can try this on your own. It's very easy, and I hope many of you must have done also, because yesterday I gave you first three questions. In class 9th, much is not there. In 10th, you will have more in statistics. Okay. So simply you will go for the formula that median is equal to n by 2th plus n by 2 plus 1th upon 2. So we will put the values n equal to 10. We will get 10 upon 2th plus 10 upon 2 plus 1th upon 2. That is the fifth and sixth term we are looking for. The fifth term is what? 1, 2, 3, 4, x. And the sixth term is x plus 2. Just put this value, x plus 2 upon 2. And this value, you know, is equal to what? Plus this value, which is a variable part, is equal to this given median. That is 63. Yes, Bhavya. So now you can easily find the value of x. But it was made possible because they have already arranged the data in ascending order. Now, question number 4, find the mode of the data. Very simple. Finding the mode. Mode is actually the value which is getting repeated maximum number of times, or you can say the value which is having maximum frequency is mode of the given data. Now, question number 5, find the mean salary of 60 workers of a factory from the table. So class, there are 60 workers in a factory and you have to find the mean salary. What they have done is they have made a frequency distribution table. Now we will understand how to find mean in the case of this sort of tables where the data is not given to you clearly, but in a tabular format to make it compact. If I just say this thing, this is x1, this is x2, this is x3, x4, x5, x6, x7 and x8. If I take only 8 terms, these one, will it be enough to find the mean like this? X bar is equal to x1 plus x2 till x8 upon 8. Will it give us the right answer? Just by taking these observations as the final one, because maybe they are representing the complete data. So can we take in this way? Class, please confirm. There are 60 workers, but they have taken only 8 values and they have drawn its frequency distribution. So finding the mean in this way will not work. Finding the mean in this way will not work because this is not the actual scenario. This 3000 is not only once. Actually, it is coming 16 times. It is coming 16 times. So you have to actually add like this 3000 plus 3000 plus 3000 till how many times? 16 times. Then you will add 4000 how many times? 12 times. 4000 plus 4000 plus 4000 12 times. Similarly, 5000 you will add 10 times. Then 6000 you will add 8 times. 7000 6 times and so on. Then you will get the total of these all observations and you will divide by what? After getting the total of all these quantities, you will divide by what? Total number of quantities, that is obviously 60. So we need to understand how to do this. We are not going to add like this. Suppose you want to add 3000 16 times, you can understand why to add. We can simply multiply because we know that repetitive addition is same as multiplication. So we will go for a new table. We will call this table as XI because these are the single observations. This I will call as FI, means frequency. This I is a variable. Okay. Now I will make a new table. XI FI, which is showing that I am multiplying X and F. Okay. So if this is X1 and this is F1, that means let me erase this once again. Class, let's understand the significance of this XI and FI. Let me enlarge this a little bit. Okay, one second. Not this one. So this is the pen. Okay, this is your XI. This is FI. Suppose XI means I is a variable going from 1 to whatever value is there. So this is your X1. This is your F1. Sorry. F1. So what will you get over here? X1 into F1. That is, yes, it is 48,000. Very good. Similarly, you have X2 into F2. What will you get? Yes. Yes, Garima. Very good. So 4,000 to 12 is 48,000 again. The third value, X3 into F3. Just to make you understand that how we are going. So it is 50,000. Then X4 into F4 is again 48,000. Then 7 into 6, 42,000. 8 fours are 32,000. 9 threes are 27. And then 10,000 at last. So class, these are actually showing the significance of 3000. It is the sum of all the 3000s. It is the sum of all the 4000s. It is the sum of all the 5000 and so on. So finally, we will write the formula as summation XI FI. You can see these are all X1 F1, X2 F2, X3 F3, X4 F4, X5 F6. In that way we are going. So I equal to 1 to where? Please tell. The last value is X8 and this is F8. So we will write summation or sigma XI FI. I goes from 1 to 8. We are starting from the first value, that is X1 F1, and we are adding till X8 F8. And what is the sum? Please tell. Tell me what is the sum of all this. Add it fast. Let me know the sum. Yes, class. Anyone, please tell the sum. 4, 5, 6, 7. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 3 lakhs. Okay. Around this, you will get the sum. You can again. Okay. Anuranjan is saying 3,05,000. Please confirm which one is correct. Yes, sir. 5,1. Okay. So it is 3,05,000 the total. Okay. What do we call this one? Actually, this is the number of observations. Or we can say it is summation FI. Because if you add all the frequencies, you will get the total number of terms. Because we cannot say that there are 8 terms. We cannot say this thing. There are actually these many terms. That is 60. So this way you can find the mean easily. How? We can say the mean is given by, in such case, when we have a frequency distribution, the formula changes. We have studied, it is given by sum of all observations upon total number of observations. This thing is same to same as this thing because it is sum of all observations. So we can write like this, summation XI FI, I goes from 1 to 8. We could have directly added the sum up as a salary and divide by 80. We are doing that only, Vaishnav. You have to consider this thing only, no? X1, F1, you have to find all these things. And then you have to add, okay? So, the sum of all observations is given by summation XI, FI, I equal to 1 to 8 divided by summation I equal to 1 to 8 Fi. So this numerator is showing the sum of all the observations. This denominator is showing the total number of terms. That's it. Things are same like earlier classes, but only difference is this new term Fi, which is the frequency, which comes in the frequency distribution table. So we have tried to make our data compact, and in the compact form, how to find the mean is this formula. This formula will help us to find the mean in the compact form. That's it. Now let's see question number 6. Give one example of a situation in which the mean is an appropriate measure of central tendency. So you can give an example, okay? And then the mean is not appropriate, but median is an appropriate. So this thing is, I am leaving on you only. You can try thinking different scenarios, and after that you can write the examples where mean is better and where median is better. Okay. So I hope these points are clear to you. Me stop the recording.